إن أعجبك الفيديو لا تنسى الإعجاب والاشتراك في القناة.
Dear respected brothers, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Allah azza wa jal help us to pray salat al-jama'ah, salat al-fajr al-jama'ah today. Alhamdulillah. May Allah azza wa jal accept all of our good deeds. Amin ya rabbil alameen. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul fi hadith, At-tuhuru shatru al-iman. والحمد لله تملأ الميزان وسبحان الله والحمد لله تملأان أو تملأ ما بين السماء والأرض والصلاة نور والصدقة برهان والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك كل الناس يغدو فبائع نفسه فمعتقها أو موبقها لقد فهمتك حديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said At-tuhur, cleanliness or purification, half of your faith, half of your faith. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we talk about purification or cleanliness, half of your faith, this is something very important. And the Muslim, he must cleanse in himself or purify himself inside and outside. Inside or outside first, as you know, when he takes shower and clean himself, and alhamdulillah, we have five times we are making wudu every day. Subhanallah, I was in my office before like 1 month, and the door was open in the bathroom, and I was making wudu. I was washing my feet. And subhanallah, a man, a guard or somebody was there, and he was telling me, how you wash your feet in the sink like this? And I told them, what is the problem? And they said, you're not supposed to do that. I told them, brother, I'm washing this five times a day. I was very polite, and I was about to tell him, this, you did not wash your face five times a day. You know, I was polite, and they would make it a big deal. I told them, just get out of here, that's it. You know, what can I do? Yeah? I want to make wudu, I want to pray my salah. Alhamdulillah, purification in Islam is something very important. This body must be clean. Yeah, outside, alhamdulillah, we take shower, and at least once a day, you can take shower, and alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, when you make wudu every day also, and you know how to make wudu in details, like what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do. And also the purification inside your heart is the must. Inside your heart, to purify your heart from all kind of illness and all of that. Sickness of hearts, you know. I mean, envy, jealous, hatred, whatever, but you can count. There are too many. Purify that heart. That's what Allah said in the Quran, and He declared, "Illa man ata Allah bi qalbin salim." Yes, those who come to Allah subhanahu wa taala with the heart which is salim, salim, يعني pure heart. Allah subhanahu wa taala created us with pure soul and spirit and heart. Being pure 100% when you come to this life. You have to go back to Him also pure. Otherwise, some people, they're gonna stay in the hellfire sometimes. Why? For this purpose, for purification. That's why He said, half of your faith to purify yourself. At-tuhur. He did not say tahur, at-tuhur, as an ism, known. As an ism, at-tuhur, cleanliness itself. Half of your faith. Walhamdulillahi tamla'u al-mizan. If I ask any one of you, which one is bigger, the mizan of Allah, the scale, or the balance, or the heaven and the earth, which one is bigger?
Mizan.
Yes, the mizan, of course, without any doubt. El mizan is scale, bigger than the heaven and the earth. That's why I said, Alhamdulillah tamla al mizan. When you say the word, Alhamdulillah, when you say this word, two words, Alhamdulillah, it will fill the mizan. Means
bigger than the earth and
heaven. Yes, means that the earth and heaven will be full more because the mizan is bigger and it will be full. Means to fulfill this heaven and the earth. Alhamdulillah, tamla al mizan. See, alhamdulillah is very important. This is one of the names of Surah Al Fatiha, Surah Al Hamd. That's why I recite the Basmala secretly in the Salah. This is a Sunnah. And I pronounce first, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. When you say Alhamdulillah, the mizan of Allah will be full of hasanat for you. good deeds and instead of what? Bad deeds. And that mizan, the scale in the day of judgment will be subhanallah, your hasanat and your sayyat, and you're going to stand in between. فالحمدلله تملأ الميزان وسبحان الله huh? Two words now. Two words. سبحان الله والحمد لله تملأ أو تملأ ما بين السماء والأرض. Between the heaven and the earth, when we say سبحان الله الحمد لله, it will be full of حسنات for you too. Good deeds. والصلاة نور. والصلاة نور. The prayer is نور, light for you. Light where? In your life, worldly life. Light. Like imagine everybody's walking in dark. There's no light. And you are the only one who has flashlight. This is your salah. It's nur for you in this world of life. Nur for you, light for you in the grave while you will be in need to the light. In the grave. Light for you the most while you need the light when you're going to be above the Sirat al-Mustaqim. Because the Sirat is full of darkness. Do you think Sirat is, mashallah, going to see to the highway there and the light is full of dark and very sharp and the hellfire under that Sirat, alhamdulillah. It is the fitna, difficult to do. Allah did do. That's why, subhanAllah, you need that light. For salah, that prayer is nur. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Surah Maryam, he mentioned some prophets, Zakaria and Musa, and Idris and Harun, Ilayat, too many prophets, Sayyidina Ibrahim, Zuriyat Noah. He mentioned these, mashallah, good prophets. Look what this ayah. He said, فخلف من بعدهم خلف أضاعوا الصلاة واتبعوا الشهوات فسوف يلقون غيا. And Rasulullah was tearing. Ya Jibreel, my brother. Oh, my brother Jibreel. Somebody of my ummah, followers, will neglect the salah. Rasul was very surprised. Somebody after me will neglect the salah. Allah is saying. He said, yes, they will do a lot. They will do a lot. أضاعوا الصلاة واتبعوا الشهوات. They will follow their desires, lusts. فسوف يلقون غيا. They will be in the valley of غيا, the hellfire. They speak. فالصلاة يا جماعة something very important for us, for Muslims. The best gift we've been gifted by Allah, الصلاة. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم being raised, elevated up to get it hand by hand from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Yes, he did not send it with Jibreel like all the أحكام الشريعة or the Quran or the Sunnah. No. Come Muhammad to me, I'll give you a special gift, the Salah. The Salah. If you miss your Salah, you miss your deen. For Salah is nur for you. Life. If you are in problem, calamities, hardship in this life, just go pray. That's it. You don't have to eat drugs or marijuana or some stuff like this. Just come to the Salah. كان صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا حزبه أمر هرع إلى الصلاة. He used to run to the Salah during his hardship time, صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, والصدقة برهان. صدقة, charity. I can talk too much, but a lot of this, but just let's go because of the time. والصدقة برهان. He said, الصدقة for you as a Muslim, it's a dalil, proof. Proof of what? Of your honesty. Because anybody can claim his mu'min, and the salah is free. Water is free, masjid is open just to pray, which is very important, the salah, I'm not saying anything. But when you come to the bucket, your bucket and your money, this is gonna hurt you a little bit. That's why he said, "Al-mal wal-banun zinat al-hayat al-dunya." People loves mal, wealth, money, and the children. Subhanallah, Allah attracted us in this dunya with these things. When you come to your bucket, you say, maybe. What? Shaitan ya'adukum al-faqr. Subhanallah, this is a way of the human being. Some people like that, but Allah said no. When you give charity, sadaqah, and sadaqah is not zakah. Sadaqah here is something voluntarily. يعني you must do zakah and the sadaqah is something extra. When you come to that extra, means you make the fard and you come plus extras, what? That voluntarily sadaqah charity, this is now proof of your honesty. Burhan. والصدقه برهان. Subhanallah, look what he said. الطهور شطر الإيمان والحمد لله تملأ الميزان وسبحان الله والحمد لله تملأ وتملأن ما بين السماء والأرض والصلاة نور number five ها والصدقة برهان. When you give your صدقة نكتة بيسموها نكتة في الحديث ها you get it with your five fingers it's number five in the hadith والصدقة برهان والصبر ضياء patience is light. Was sabr diya. What kind of light? Light with energy. Because diya in the Quran, in Arabic, or the Quran, is different from the word nur. Surah Yunus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that. هو الذي جعل لكم الشمس وهو الذي جعل الشمس ضياء والقمر نورا. الضياء والنور in English means light. But in Arabic, no, different. يبقى الشمس الضياء. When he mentioned the sun, he mentioned ضياء. When he mentioned the moon, the reflection of the light of the sun, النور. يبقى the light of the sun comes with what? Energy.
Energy and light.
And light. Ayo. And the light of the moon is just a reflection of the light. We understand one thing here. It may look like sabr, patience. Huh? Diya. Like the sun. Sometimes you give up. You are in failure. You're tired. You're sick. Poverty. Problems. You are down now. Completely down. But when you have that sabr, what's going to happen? You're going to stand with energy. Give you energy again to stand. That's why the Muslims, they doesn't care about whatever can happen. They are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These people sometimes with little calamity like this, they execute themselves. They cannot hold it. They said, "Khalas, let me finish it. Let me destroy the temple." I'm going to destroy the temple because khalas, I cannot hold it anymore. Ya Allah, khalas, kharbar. That's why it was sabr diya, very important, patience. And Allah mentioned the sabr in the Quran 90 times. The last 18 times, this sabr was sabr, but 90, I said sabr. Count 90 means something important. You have to, that's it. Sabr is something very important, especially your hardship time. Then the reward of it, Jannah without accountability. There is no measure. There is no. Allah will not count you. Allah said in Surah Al-Zumar, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. أيوة حق. بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. صبر على الطاعة، صبر عن المعصية، صبر على الألام والمصائب. Three types of صبر. This very important. Last thing in the Hadith, he said, والقرآن حجة لك وعليه. القرآن, that's a proof. It's a proof with you. We'll take your hand to Jannah. Or that Quran will be presented as a human in the day of judgment, will push somebody from his back into his fire like this. Yeah. أو عليك against you. القرآن, listen. Listen. Read. Memorize. Follow it, its rules. Apply it in your life. And cure your illness with the Quran too. شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. هداية, guidance. Al-Quran al-Kareem, very important, ya jama'ah. This is some of the rights of Al-Quran upon us. Kalam Allah, the best. Kalam Allah, Quran al-Kareem. The Holy Quran, subhanallah. He said, Al-Quran hujjatun laka aw alayhi. Quran will intercede for you on the day of judgment. Mahirun musaddaq, attorney, but honest attorney, not liar, fake. He said, Al-Quran mahirun, يعني attorney. Musaddaq, whatever the Quran say, Allah will say it. Just say it. Musaddaq, that's it. That's it. For the Quran, subhanAllah, read it, ya jama'ah. You will be higher than Jibreel if you read the Quran perfectly. Subhanallah, قال المهر بالقرآن مع النبي مع ال مع السفرة الكرام البررة والذي يقرأه عليه وهو يتتعتع فيه له أجرها. If you read the Quran while you're learning, you will be rewarded twice for each letter 20 حسنة. But if you read it perfectly, like the way of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and Jibreel, you will be in the level of Jibreel in Jannah, السفرة الكرام البررة, like Angel Jibreel. Mikael, Seraphim, subhanAllah, these great angels, those who are traveling between the heavens, they're going to be in high level in Jannah. Yeah, اقرأ وارتقى ورتل كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا فإن منزلتك عند آخر تقرأها أكل من الحديث. فالقرآن حجة لك وعليه. كل الناس يغدو فبائع نفسه. Everybody, every person Allah create, subhanAllah, he's waking up in the morning, يغدو الغدو عليك this time. صلاة الغداء, صلاة الغداء means in the morning time. Everybody is going in his own way in the morning time. Some people, they are going in the way of Rahman like you. First thing you did, you are making every morning what? Wudu, coming to the masjid. You are in the way of Rahman from the beginning, alhamdulillah. This is a big gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanAllah, later you will recognize what you are doing now. And you say, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. This guidance. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. فكل الناس يغدو فبايع نفسه. How to بايع نفسه؟ بايع نفسه للرحمن. ها؟ فمعتقها أو موبقها. If you go in the way of الرحمن, you will save your نفس from the hellfire. If you go to the way of الشيطان مهلكها, you will destroy yourself. This is the meaning of the hadith. فبايع النفس فمعتقها, you will save yourself from the hellfire, destruction of the hellfire. أو موبقها يعني مهلكها. If you follow the way of الشيطان. This is good hadith for فضائل الأعمال. Try to increase, inshallah, رقائق. Try to increase this good deeds, تسبيح, الذكر, الصلاة, الصبر, making صدقة. Start your day with the way of, follow the way of Allah, الرحمن سبحانه وتعالى. Allah will give you all رحمة, inshallah. You will be under his رحمة, inshallah. I'm asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى to help all of us to make more good deeds, inshallah. I'm asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى to forgive all of us, to shower us with his mercy, رحمة, tranquility, هداية. يا رب العالمين, ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. صلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير, إن شاء الله. The family light between Maghrib and Isha today, إن شاء الله. جزاكم الله خير. May Allah accept it.